Happy Friday. Phil Lindemann with your news from Avalanche Physical Therapy on Crystal 93. That's the sound of hail from inside a car when a torrential downpour with lightning rolled through Dillon just before 3 p.m. Hundreds of cars were sitting out in it, jammed up on US Highway 6. Forecast calls for more rain and possibly hail through the weekend and flash flooding across the high country, especially on burn scars. Summit has been slammed this summer, and Health Director Amy Wineland says that is diluting our 78% COVID vaccination rate.
Since July 4th, Summit County has averaged almost 3 visitors per resident. So this is tied with San Miguel for the highest among resort counties. We love our visitors. They're really critical for our economic recovery. But they are playing a role here too.
Cell phone mobility data shows many visitors are coming from places with lower vaccination rates, dragging the effective rate here as low as 65%. This has not sent more people to the hospital yet.
Typically, we see increases in numbers in cases, and then to follow, typically we see hospitalizations increase, which is what we are seeing across the state right now.
Leading the surge in Summit and most of the nation is the Delta variant. Wineland explained how Delta is just as contagious as chickenpox, one reason it is sickening even vaccinated people.
The vaccines, though not 100% effective, will prevent severe illness, hospitalizations, and deaths.
The final message from public health: if you have been at concerts, baseball games, or other public events, get tested when you feel sick, or even if you don't feel sick, 3 to 5 days after your event. Delta is notorious for asymptomatic transmission. Get tested for free at Centura, the Care Clinic, or Bryan Avenue in Silverthorne. The county has extended the local public health order through end of August with no changes. Face masks are only required for children ages 2 to 11 at indoor child care and camps. Summit County Coroner has identified the man who died dirt biking in Dillon this week as 58-year-old Richard Stevens of Cincinnati. Stevens collapsed while riding with a group above the disc golf course on Tenderfoot Mountain. He died of a heart attack. 1 week after convening dozens of stakeholders for a housing think tank, Summit County Commissioners today held a town hall explaining what comes next. Tamara Pogue.
We really are trying to put together a multi-pronged approach to mitigation that we hope will create some immediate, middle, and long-term relief.
The board covered 8 major initiatives, like new construction in Dillon and Frisco and rezoning for tiny homes, and then took questions from virtual attendees. We'll be covering those next week. By far, the most popular topic was short-term rentals, and if Summit will follow other ski towns like Steamboat Springs with a licensing moratorium. County Commissioner Josh Blanchard says that will not happen.
Summit County government is not anti-STR. We recognize the importance that short-term rentals play on our economy. We know that that infrastructure is absolutely required in order for us to maintain the workforce that we have, as well as to host the visitors coming to Summit County.
Of the 4,300 short-term rentals in unincorporated Summit, 75% are in Copper and Keystone.
Those were developed and designed for short-term rentals. Those are the folks who are coming here from out of state with their families, spending $10,000 on a ski vacation.
Instead, the county will focus on 1,000 units in opportunity zones, neighborhoods like Wilderness and Summit Cove, where locals have traditionally lived. I-70 at Glenwood Canyon is closed again for the 5th time this summer. What kind of damage is that doing to the 4-hour detour through Kremling, Steamboat, Craig, and Meeker? Mike Goolsby with CDOT.
You know, US 40 is a priority, State Highway 9, 131, all of those for the northern detour route. But we will have to go out and do some additional maintenance to take care of some of these areas that are beat up pretty bad.
Glenwood Canyon might remain closed through the weekend with more rain on the way. Keep it tuned to Crystal for the latest. In other more uplifting I-70 news, the westbound express lane between Veterans Memorial Tunnel and Empire is now open after 3 years and $70 million. Better yet, the express lane is free for now, open weekends and holidays. Tolling begins later this year. In sports, the Rockies play the Padres tonight at 8:10. And in local sports, brought to you by American Family Insurance, the Weiss Agency, Race 3 of the Summit Trail Running Series is next week, August 4th, at the Classic Baker's Tank 7K and 11K. Register through BreckenridgeRecreation.com. Phil Lindemann with your news from Avalanche Physical Therapy on Crystal 93.